Physical education is taught in schools during primary and secondary education. It promotes psychomotor learning by using movement exploration setting to promote health and fitness. PE helps pupils to develop the skills, knowledge, and competencies to live healthy lives. Considering the many benefits of physical education, many elementary teachers find teaching this subject difficult. In this study, the different challenges they encounter in teaching PE will be identified, rated, and analyzed. The results from the study of Renata Osborne: obstacles for physical education teachers in public schools, an unsustainable situation, indicated that the major difficulties faced were low wages, precarious infrastructure, and lack of materials. Physical education is devalued, the space allocated is inadequate, and it is treated as mere recreation. In order to collect data, a random selection of 50 key stage 1 and 2 physical education teachers from Bunga Primary School, Maximino V. Pangilinan Elementary School, and Punta Elementary School was used. The following statistical tools were used in the interpretation of the results according to solved problems: frequency, percentage, weighted mean, ranking. On the problems encountered, the Likert scale was used to evaluate the result, and the following equivalent is given. As manifested in the data, 4 indicators were rated highly encountered. These are: first, difficulty in the assessment of the PE students' tasks and activities, weighted gain 4.18. Second, teachers face difficulties to follow activities with the students whether or not they complete the assigned tasks at home, weighted gain 4.27. Third, qualified teachers often lack the confidence and competence to teach physical education, weighted gain 4.25. And fourth, physical education teachers feel pressured to deliver as much physical activity as possible, weighted gain 4.23. While the remaining indicators were rated moderately encountered. Based on the findings of the study, the researchers came up with an intervention scheme to address the challenges in teaching physical education. The intervention scheme is illustrated in a matrix form featuring the problems, intervention, impact measure, approach, and success indicators. The matrix hopes to respond to the problems faced. Needless to say, if young people are to achieve their full potential in PE and develop their motivation skills, the school needs a well-qualified teacher who can deliver quality lessons that engage, challenge, and inspire all learners. The following are the recommendations. First, take immediate action and solutions to the identified problems encountered to improve the academic performance of learners in physical education. Second, the proposed intervention scheme should be adapted to provide baseline information for policy formulation and the training and development of teachers. Third, other researchers may replicate this using additional variables to recruit or confirm results and findings.